10-minute quarter. And it is time to go to work here at Bardo Gym this afternoon. Ball's in the air, and College of St. Elizabeth will control with AshleyPledger out on the wing. It'll go outside to Rogers. Rogers drives the baseline, shots up no good. Rogers gets her own rebound. Ball's passed back out as the Eagles will reset with Pledger. Inside it goes. This is Ingram. Ingram's shots up and no good. Loose ball. Penn College runs the ball. They don't get it as Pledger will come away with the loose ball. So it's now another opportunity here for the Lady Eagles, and a deep three that time by Emery's Rogers, and it will be now. Here we go, Wildcats, 4-0 mark of the first quarter. Into the front court from the Lady Eagles. Down it goes as it finally winds up in the hands of Sanders. Sanders passes over to Rogers. Rogers on the wing. Down low it goes. Outside to Sanders. Now around the ledge. She'll shoot the deep two. Shots up no good. Outside the rebound to Rogers. Back around it comes. Pledger will have it. Pledger looks to drive. Now instead brings it out. Pledger down the lane. Shots up. Off glass. Good. Good. She will go to the line for an and one opportunity. As AshleyPledger at the line looking to try to play. First Penn College foul goes on Mowry. It'll be her first team. Next free throw is up here by Pledger. She will hit the shot. And the College of St. Elizabeth cuts the deficit. That's still lead. Now it's Keegan looking to drive it all the way in. Layup's no good. Ball rebound by Steer. Pull up tees, no good. Rebounded on the backside by Ingram. Now here come the Lady Eagles the other way. This is with Pledger. Now Rogers controls, looks for space. She's picked up by Moss. Now the pass comes back out to Robinson. Robinson, Pledger. Pledger down the lane, lost the handle, ball stolen. This is Mowry. Danielle Mowry will control this. 13-11 with 2:45 here in the first quarter. Oh, nice up and under and layup drive that time by Pledger. As the Eagles reclaim a 4-point lead. 15-11 Eagles. 2:35 left here in the first. Ball controlled by Ross. Pass ahead to Ingram. Penn College into the front court. And Ross looks to drive. Now she squares for three. That's no good. Loose ball and the rebound. Caroms back down to Pledger. Pledger looks to drive. Gets in the lane. Lays it up and good. And now the Lady Eagles have the biggest lead in the ball game of six. It's 17-11. Final in the U.S. Pledger the other way. Another breakaway and score. And the Wildcats now find themselves down. It's 19-11 with 40 seconds left here in the first quarter. As the Eagles have extended to their biggest lead of the game. Pass inside to Battle. Shots up, no good. Berger runs down the offensive rebound. Ball's tapped into the corner to Alicia Ross. She'll shoot the three. That's no good. Loose ball and Sanders down with the rebound for the Lady Eagles. Down to the final 20 seconds of the first quarter. The Lady Eagles will hold for the final shot. Into the corner it goes to Pledger back around Robinson. She shoots from 18. Shots up, no good. Loose ball. Sherilyn Sanders will move out and put back with 7 seconds left. And the Lady Eagles now lead by 10. Final 2 seconds tick away here in the first. And that shot by Ross. Ooh. All right, let's get back to game action here. As we are here with the Marist King, the Lady Eagles have it. Pledger for three, and that is good. And that will extend the lead to 26-7 for the ratio here in the second. Ball for the Lady Wildcats. Ball into the corner, it goes to Mowry. Now back down low again to Ross. She tries to bounce that back. A little defense to try and cut back into this lead from the Eagles. Alright, game action resumes, 7:13 in the game. He looks somewhere to go, won't find anywhere. She drives to the block, lays it up, no good. Timing as we are underway now, second half action, third quarter just beginning here at Bardo Gym. Ball in the hands of the Lady Eagles to start this second half. As it'll will be Fletcher over to LeShae Robinson for two, and the Lady Eagles pick right up where they left off in that first half, and their lead now is up to 16. 44-28. Now ball in the hand of Melissa Keegan. Here come the Lady Wildcats for their first offensive possession. Ball goes to Ross, now back around to Mallory, now Steers. Into the corner goes Williams. Williams inside, now outside with Ross. Ross drives the lane, layup's no good. Ball here, almost had it, now has it, puts it up, no good. First ball, rebound at Sanders for the Lady Eagles as we are just about underway in this first minute here in the third quarter as Fletcher kicks it off to Rogers. Rogers back over to Sharon Sanders, pull up two from the free throw line, is no good. First ball, now on the floor, it is a 15, it is 44-28, College of St. Elizabeth. All right, 2 minutes gone by here in the third. We are under 8 minutes to play. Ball controlled by Ross. Ross over to Mallory. Mallory looks, ball knocked away, and scored by Sharon Sanders ahead to LeShae Robinson. Robinson looks to drive. Shot's no good. Pleasure there for the scooping score on the backside. And the lead for the College of St. Elizabeth is now up to 18. It's 46-28, Lady Eagles. Lady Wildcats get into the front court with Marissa Keegan. Keegan, bounce pass goes to Ross. Ross, cross court. Keegan, pull up three is good. And the Wildcats get the basket there. The Wildcats down to victory. Ball is really score rather now. 46-31, ball controlled by Fletcher. Around it goes to Robinson. Now it goes into the side wing to Rogers. Down the lane, out to Robinson, and now Fletcher. 3 minutes gone by here in the third as we are under 7 minutes showing in the quarter. Shot clock at 11. Fletcher inside to Ingram. Layup is good. And we are back up to a 17-point lead. The largest of the day has been 18 by the Lady Eagles. Game clock at 6:43 here in the third. 48-31, College of St. Elizabeth. Mallory tries to pass down the right here. Ball stolen away by Ingram. Ingram goes cross court. This is Fletcher. Fletcher looks to drive. Layup is up and good. And the Eagles have their biggest lead of the day at 19. It's 50-31 in favor of the College of St. Elizabeth. Mallory drives inside. Ball's out to Naisha Williams, and that will be knocked away and a foul to Williams. All right, now here we go, and Mallory will have it outside. Now here we go, as the pass is over to Fletcher. Now Robinson, that's an actual pass on the way on his foot. And the Eagles lead has swollen to the biggest of the day at 52-31. 5:40 left here in the third. Oh, Ross with a nice job down the lane. Now put the lead at 52-34 as the Wildcats deficit is back down to 18. Ball controlled now by Fletcher into the corner. Rogers, pull up two, it's good. And that will extend the lead again back to 20. Down to 5 minutes showing here in the third. Here, pull up two, gets the two ball. That'll be 17 and the ball now is
43.
Minutes remain here in the third as we hit the halfway point. Fletcher looks inside to Ingram. Ingram down low to Sanders. Sanders over the back, and that will be another for the College of St. Elizabeth. Ball now controlled by Mallory of Penn College. Mallory pass deflected, stolen by Fletcher, and the layup is good. Now it's up to 19 points. Mallory. And Steers' layup is no good. Rebounded Rogers. And back the other way come the Lady Eagles. 3:18 left here in the third quarter. Ball controlled now by Fletcher. Fletcher looks around. Clock is at 3:09 here in the third. Ball stolen by Ross. Ross looking to drive. And she will lay it in. Back up to a 21-1. Our score, final 13 seconds left here in this quarter, and a foul called away from the basket as Tatiana Curtis will get called.
That was on St. Elizabeth's foul. 15, Tatiana Curtis.
That's going to send Alicia Roth.
Her first two over the limit.
Roth will go to the line for a pair with 10 seconds left. Free throw is up and good. She'll have one more. And ready. Roth shoots and it is good. Well, there we go. And Roth hits the free throw. The score is now 67-46. Final 6 seconds left in the quarter. Curtis drives the drive. Pull up shot, no good. Loose ball, Roth, and that will win. 8:30 quarter. So,